Look closely the next time you're driving through the countryside of Georgia, and you just might see Big Bird. Not the one from Sesame Street, but a real Big Bird. Like an 8-foot ostrich from Africa, an emu from Australia, or their South American cousin, the rhea. Today, there are no boundary lines in the world of business. We sell products to countries around the globe, and they sell things to us, including some very large, very strange-looking birds. Fowler Farms in Albany, Georgia, is managed by Wayne Fowler and his family. For years, they supplied exotic animals to zoos and parks. This year, Wayne and his business partner, Suzanne Shingler, started a new business. They sell, guess what? Not beef, but ostrich, emu, and rhea meat to restaurants and grocery stores. These birds may look weird, but people around the world are finding out they taste good.
China in particular is very interested in these birds. They've been importing them. We just sent 92 ostriches over to an area between Shanghai and Beijing. So they're considered to be an alternative livestock. You can put a large number of them on a relatively small amount of land. 98% of the animal is usable. You can use the meat, you can use the feathers, the hides are marketable.
It's like you say, the most valuable part of this whole industry is the amount of meat you can raise on such a small area, mm-hmm. as opposed to cattle, because you can only have one cow per acre, whereas you can put probably 20 birds per acre.
Oil from the emu and rhea is also very valuable.
Yeah, the emu has a fat pack right at the base of the tail. You can see on this bird here where it flattens out. And it's several pounds and it makes a oil that is good pharmaceutical. It's good for rubbing on sore muscles. I know the Denver Broncos use it for their football players. But historically, the emu has been with the Aborigine in Australia, and they have eaten the meat, they use the leather, they use the feathers. And it's a very productive bird. Just about every part of it can be used for something.
Now these are the ostrich eggs.
Raising these birds is also fairly easy. Since the birds are from warm climates, Suzanne hatches the eggs inside in incubators during the winter. An omelet from one egg could feed 12 people. The emu and rhea eggs are slightly smaller. Most of the birds, like these emu chicks, are hatched inside. But when the weather warms up, Suzanne lets her emus hatch their eggs on their own outdoors. The interesting thing about emus is that they heard about women's liberation long before people. Once the female lays the eggs, she takes off, leaving the male to sit on them until they hatch.
Every woman says she loves you.
Before he started sitting, he ate ravenously and stored up his fat. And so now that he is sitting on the eggs, he will sit now for 58 to 63 days. And very seldom will he get up and go eat and drink.
Today in Georgia, there are 1,000 farms raising emu, ostrich, and rhea. Most are mom and pop operations just starting out. The industry is still in its infancy, but the meat is becoming increasingly popular.
Especially since everybody's going to a low-fat, low-cholesterol meat. And the ostrich, emu, and rhea meat offers only 1.5 grams of fat and 3 ounces of meat, and the lowest cholesterol of any meat available today.
The birds are considered livestock, not poultry, because their meat is red, not white. Wonder what it tastes like? We did, so we went to Carr's Steakhouse, the only restaurant serving red bird meat in Albany. We asked a few people how they liked it.
It's very good. I mean, it's juicy. It tastes just like beef to me. I couldn't tell the difference if I didn't know it.
I'm having the emu, also steak, and it's excellent. It's very tender.
It's good. I think it's weird. And you hear about it, but it tastes wonderful. This is the ostrich. It's pretty good. It kind of tastes like steak to me.
Big bird ranching has become one of the fastest growing agricultural industries in the U.S. The market is growing, and pioneering Georgians are getting in on the business. Who knows, the next time you go out to eat, you may want to try an ostrich steak medium rare. Or how about a roasted rhea with potatoes and gravy? Or for just a light lunch, how about a double emu burger with cheese? But if little kids are around, just don't order the Big Bird special.
The American Emu Association estimates that there are 10,000 American families raising emus today.
It's time to say farewell. This is the last program in the series Georgia Stories. I hope you've enjoyed it, at least most of it, and have learned something. I know I have. We wouldn't have done this series if it hadn't been for you. This is Georgia Stories. I'm Colin Seador. Thanks.